Hello guys, in this video I am going to discuss keypad interfacing with microcontroller. Before going to start programming, let's understand basics of a keypad. Keypad is basically made up of switches. The push button switches are arranged as a matrix as shown in the below image. So there are different types of keypads like 4x3 keypad, the left one, and 4x4 keypad, the right one. So 4x3 keypad means there are switches arranged as a matrix, that means as 4 rows and 3 columns as shown in the left side image. So that means whenever the user press button 1, that is this one, so that means there is a short circuit from row 1 to column 1. Whenever the user press button 2, then there is a short from row 1 to column 1. So the now the path is closing from row 1 like this and through this switch to column 2. So there is a short circuit from row 1 to column 2 whenever the user press button 2. So like that. So and so on, it will work like if you take for any switch, like whenever the user press button 0 here, this one, so then there is a short circuit from row 4 to column 2.
We need to write a program logic for all these possible conditions. 4x3 means total there are 12 possible conditions, and similarly it works for 4x4 keypad. So 4x4 means total we need to write 4 into 4, total 16 possible combinations. So and the real hardware keypad looks like this. So there is a 4x3, that means 4 plus 3, 7 pins we need for interfacing 4x3.
Now let's see a circuit diagram for this 4x3 keypad. In this circuit, the 4x keypad connected to port 1 as input. This is connected to port 1. And the output LED is connected to port 2 as shown here. That means whenever the user press button 1 here, so there is a short circuit from row 1 to column 1, so there is a signal change in the port 1 input. So based on this input change, we are writing a logic like to display the value on the LEDs. For example, whenever the user press button 1, then the LEDs, it has to display 1, like it will display in as a binary format like 00000001. So only last LED is 1, remaining zeros for value 1. So whenever the user press button 2, then the LED is displays 2 in binary format like 00000010. So the last but one, one remaining zeros. So that is nothing but number 2. So it will display like that. So we need to write a program for this. Now let's start write program for this. So this as I told, the output LED is connected to P2 and the keypad is connected to port 1. So we need to define these two. And the initially all output values should be 0. So we need to make output LEDs to 0. And then infinity loop. So all these basics we already discussed in previous videos. Now let's start writing a main logic. So the main logic will be whenever we need to give some value to keypad, like, so I'm just giving keypad equal to 0xFE. The hexadecimal value, that means, so what's the meaning of 0xFE? So 0x P1 is connected to keypad, as you know. So if you see FE, so the value will be like this. So only the last position is 0, remaining ones. So this represents 0xFE. So this 0th port 1 0th position, if you see in the circuit, so port 1 0th one is connected to row 1. So that means we are making a row 1, this row 1 as 0, and checking the column conditions at that time. So now this position is 0, row 1. So that means whenever the user press first button, then the column 1 will get that 0 signal. So whenever the row 1 is 0 and whenever the user press button 2, then there is a short circuit from row 1 to column 2. So the 0th signal is connected to column 2. So there are another condition, like whenever the row 1 is 0, whenever the user press button 3, then the 0th signal is connected to column 3. So we are going to write this condition first, that is for row 1 0, and checking column 1, column 2 and column 3 conditions. So let me write a program for this. So initially I made a row 1 to 0, and I'm checking the three columns, column 1, column 2, column 3. So using if, so whenever the user press first button for imagine, so then the condition will be keypad will be 0x if keypad equal to is equal to 0x EC. So EC means can understand from the circuit, like, so now this row 1 is 0, that means suppose imagine now the user press button 1, then this signal is going to this point, that means port 1 fourth pin is 0. So we'll make port 1 fourth pin 0, then we will see this, what's the value. So that is this one. So this is nothing but whenever the row 1 is 0, then whenever the user press first button, then this position is that is making it as 0. That is nothing but EE. Sorry, it is not EC, this is EE. So then the condition will be Gx EE. That means the user press button 1. So and then what should be the out LED's value here? It will be, it should be 1. So this is the first condition for displaying number value 1 whenever the user press first button. So this should be our hexadecimal value. So that means whenever there is a key equal to 0x EE. So as I explained, EE comes whenever the user press first button. So we are giving applying signal here. Now this signal, whenever the user press first button, then the signal is coming to this position from the schematic. So now let's continue writing for other conditions. The second condition is like for button 2. So that means the next condition will be like Gx DE. So if the keypad is whenever the signal is 0 for row 1, so and we are checking the condition like Gx DE. So DE is nothing but whenever the user press button 2, so this condition will occur. Let's see how it will come. So initially this value is 0, remaining ones. This initial condition is 0xFE. So whenever the user press button 2, for example, so that means now the signal is here. So whenever the user press button 2, that is this one, so already this row is 0, so this 0 signal is going to this pin, that is port 1 fifth pin will be 0. That means this position will be 0. So whenever the user press button 2, so this is for button 1, previous condition. So what will be the hexadecimal value for this? This is 13. 13 is nothing but D E. So this already we written in our program. So that is the reason it will be Gx DE. So now the out LED's value should be 2. So that means whenever the keypad user press button 2, so we have to display number 2. So like that we will write the third condition for this row 1. So that is the next condition will be BE. So if keypad equal to BE, so that means whenever the user press button 3. So whenever the user press button 3, so the keypad we are checking whenever the input is Gx BE. So when the initial condition is Gx FE. So then the output LED should be 3. So now let's check how it will be BE from schematic. Now for example, this position is we are giving 0 from row 1, and we are checking this column 3 condition. That means, so now you give 0 here signal, the 0 signal will go to port 1 6th position. So then the value will be 0, and this is the initial condition. We are applying row 1 0 and we are checking column 3 whether it is pressed or not. So the equivalent hexadecimal will be, this is 11, that is nothing but BA. This is whenever the user press button 3. So that is the reason we written keypad equal to is equal to 0xBA. So then the output LED is equal to 3. So this is for row 1. So we have to continue similarly for row 2 and row 3. So according to the circuit. So now we written code for only row 1. So we have to continue row 2, row 3 and row 4. I'm just copy pasting these lines. So I'm going to use Notepad++ for editing. So now we are going to write for now we are going to write program for row 2. So that means we are giving row 2 0 and checking whether 4, 5, 6 buttons. This is 4, 5, 6 buttons. Which one is pressed? So according to the schematic, 4, 5, 6. So now the values will change. As I explained, so similarly this will be FD, and we need to check for ED. So that displays number 4. Next DD, that displays number 5. Next, BD, this displays number 6. So now I am going to continue for even for row 3. Just copy paste, change the values according to row 3. So now row 3 we are making 0, that is nothing but FB. And we are checking conditions like EB, that displays 7, 8, 9. This is 7, this is 8, and this is 9. So EB is for 7. DB is for 8. BB for 9. So the last condition we need to write, like for row 4, if it is 0, so that it will be the last row. So for last row, if you see the schematic, this is the last row. There will be there is no number. There is a number 0 and star and hash. So we are going to display star hash here. So I'm going to display it as a character, so by using a single quote. Let's see that. The condition will be like whenever the row 3 equal to 0, that means the condition will be like F7. So you can check that if you want. So the for row 3, if you see, if you give 0 here, that means this position is port 13 is 0. That is, this one is 0, that is initial condition. So remaining one here, one. So this position is 1 for row 3 0. So whenever this is 0, we are checking these values. So which button is pressed? So that means if it is pressed the first button, this will be 0. For second, it will be fourth row second button, it will be 0. Fourth row third button, that is hash, it will be 0. So based on this, the code will change. So that is the initial condition F7. This is 7. 0 triple 1 means that is 7. So whenever it is F7, so if the user press button star button, for example, then the code will be E7. So then we have to display star. So I'm just giving it as character. That's the reason I'm using single quotes. The next condition is D7. At D7, it gives the value 0. There's a middle position. And next is B7. This is for displaying hash in single quotes. So that means this is for star display, this is for 0, and this is for hash. Let's save this. So now all the 9 conditions, that is for, sorry, 12 conditions, that is a first row 3 conditions, second row 3 conditions, third row 3 conditions, fourth row 3 conditions. So 4 threes are 12 conditions we have written. So let's execute this in KL. There is no error. Let's go to the schematic, flash the software. Play it. So whenever the user press first button, it has to display 1 as shown here. So whenever the user press button 2, it is displaying number 2 on LEDs. That is our expected output. So whenever the user press 3, it is displaying 3. So whenever the user press 4, 100 means 4, 5, 0101, 6, 0110, 7, 0111, 8, 9, 0, 0 means all off. Suppose if I want to display a star, how it will display? So as you know, we given it as a character, so it will display ASCII value of this character. So ASCII value of this star can see here. So ASCII of star is 42, so which is hexadecimal equivalent is 0x2a. So as you see, the binary value also here 0010 1010. So same here it is displaying. That is 2A. So as you see, for similarly for ASH also, it will display ASCII value. So ASCII value for hash, if you see, that is 0x23. The binary will be 0010 0011. That is 0x23. So it is working fine. Now let's write a program to display this keypad values in a LCD. Now we will see displaying keypad values in LCD display. So we already discussed LCD display interfacing in previous video. I recommend to watch this my previous video for better understanding. So we already made interfacing this 16x2 LCD with the microcontroller. So now let's start our write a program for this. So displaying keypad values in LCD display. So before that, let's have a look on the schematic or circuit diagram for this. So the keypad is interfaced to port 1 as input, and output we have LCD display, 16x2 LCD display, which is connected to port 2, and there are some control pins which are connected to port 30 and port 31. So let's have a look on the program. So I already written. So as for the circuit, keypad is connected to port 1 and the LCD is connected to P2, the data lines, and the control lines connect to port 30 and 1. So for cursor position, I took one variable, and all these functions are related to LCD. So we already discussed in the previous video LCD interfacing. So this is for to get a key from the keypad. So just now we discussed this program. So how to get a key. So this already we discussed. So I just moved this whole logic to a separate function, that is get key, keypad key. So if you call this function, the return value will be the key value pressed by the user. So let's start this main logic. Like, so there is a key value I took, that is initially 0, and there is a LCD command 0x38, 0x0c, all these we discussed in previous video. So next, the main logic will be in while of 1. So the simple logic we can write like, so as you know, there is a LCD cursor position. So maximum in LCD display we can display maximum in a single row we can display 16 characters, and the second row we can display another 16. So total we can display only 32 characters on this display. So just to differentiate, if it is less than 16, that is it has to display in first row. So if it is greater than or equal to 0 to 15, that is first row, that is 16 characters we can display in first row. The first row command is 0x80, and that means 0x80 plus the cursor position. For example, now the cursor for first key button press, the cursor position is 0. So 0x80 plus 0 is 0x80, that is first position. So 0x for second character press, second button press, then the value of this one will be incremented in this function, as you see here. So now the if the person press second value, now the value is incremented. So that value we are adding here. So to move the cursor position to next position, this is a simple logic. So if the characters reach 15, that is 0 to 15, so total 16 characters displayed in first row. So in that case, next the cursor value is 16. So if it is greater than or equal to 16, so what we are moving the cursor to next row, that is first row over. So we need to write it in second row, the remaining 16 characters. So for that we need this logic. So that means of for moving to second row, it is 0x0 command, and the cursor position is now after 16, it will give 17. So 17 minus 16, it will give 1. So that means if you want to display in 0xC1 means that is second position of second row. So this is a simple logic just to navigate the cursor from first row to second row. So and if the two rows are full, that means 32 characters displayed. So in that case, now the cursor value is, it will come as 32 or greater than 32. So in that case, we need to clear the LCD. For the clearing LCD, we are using just 0x01 command, and we need to again the LCD cursor position, we need to reset to 0. So these logics just for display handling. So just to move for first row or second row or clearing the LCD. So the main logic will be this one only. Like if keep, we are just reading, we are getting keypad value from this function, get keypad key. So this already we discussed, this logic we already discussed earlier. So next, so we are getting the key value. Suppose user press 1, we will get 1. So if user press 2, we will get 2, like that. So now we got the key value. So this key value we are sending to a LCD. So now this is just a character variable. So then just passing to a LCD data function. So if you see definition of this function, so it is going to LCD data. So it is going to LCD data to display data. So this function we already discussed in the previous video. So there will be some delay after this. So like this, the loop will be repeated for scanning different values pressed by the user. So then we are displaying in a LCD. So this is just a simple logic we can write. So now let's execute this. Flash the software, play it. So now I'm just would like to display 1 at the first position. So it is displaying. So second, So second I press it two times, so it is 2 2, 3 and 4 5 6. So you can press like this, you can press any button randomly. So even for star also I made it as a star character, and for ash also there is a ash character 0. So you can display up to 16 characters in first row. So once it completes 16, now it's completed 16 characters, immediately the cursor will move to the second row. So that logic we already handled in the program. So if you press next button, it will automatically will go to the second row. So we can write the second row also. So after completing second row, immediately we handle that. So it has to clear the LCD of 32 characters. So because of that, it's cleared. So again, we can write. So like this we can display anything. So depends on the application, we can write a different text. So just try to make a different applications using this combination, keypad and LCD. Next I would like to I'm just posting interview questions in the community tab of my channel. So every day I'm posting one question here, as you see. So just try to answer. This will be real embedded interview questions. Just check this. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned.